NoMoreOp4 here, taking a look at the Sling Bow. Now, first thing I want to say here is that I did not create this. This idea, at least as far as I know, came from Dave Canterbury with Pathfinders. I believe their YouTube channel is called Wilderness Outfitters. Dave Canterbury has a show on Discovery Channel basically talking about survivalist strategies in the outdoors, but I just wanted to go through a step-by-step kind of showing of how to make the sling bow, since they really never went through everything. I mean, it's clearly, as you can see here, not very complicated, but either way, just thought it'd be good to go through it for some people. Now obviously the main component is a slingshot. You can see here, this is just a Daisy power line. You can get it for 10 bucks at any Walmart or Dick's Sporting Goods. You can see here I left on the sling bands that come with the gun. You can get a stronger pair, but for the purposes of this video, I will be leaving the regular yellow ones on. You need 2 zip ties. I mean, pretty inexpensive. You can find those in any hardware store. 1 whisker biscuit. Now, make sure when you get the whisker biscuit that it has 2 secure points on here. This is for, if you don't know what a whisker biscuit is, it is for compound bows. It's actually what you slide the arrow into before you release it. If I can get a picture of my buddy's bow, I'll show you. But basically, it's just for sliding the arrow in. It keeps it in place, so you don't have to hold it in your hand when you have it at draw. You know, it's the other point. So you hold it back, and it sits in the whisker biscuit just like that, and it slides through right through there like that. So. You can see here, you might notice that I did not get full-size arrows for the purpose of this, just trying to keep it on a budget. These are pretty cheap gold tips. They're youth arrows. So I think this was like $5 for 3 arrows. But for the purpose of this survival video, how to build a sling bow, this will suffice just fine. And then, of course, you're going to need, at least in Dave's video, he used golf tees to insert in the bottom of the arrows for added grip. That's a great idea. For youth arrows, most golf tees will not fit because they're too wide for the shaft of the arrow. So, in this case, that's not going to apply. And I'll probably end up doing a revision where I get a full-sized arrow to use. But I wanted to keep it real simple and real light for my specific one here. Anyway, one additional point that I thought of for fishing, and Dave might have talked about this, maybe. I watched some of his channels, some of his videos, but not all of them. When fishing, drill a hole into this, just a small hole, small enough that you can fit a strong, at least some sort of strong string, maybe a pretty heavy pound fishing line, something like that, and you can actually tie it off. So when you're actually aiming for fish, if you can't make a fishing rod and you only have your sling bow, you can actually bow fish from the side of the lake or stream, or maybe in the middle of the stream if you're standing out there, if you can't make a fishing rod, and you can actually bow fish with this, with that tactic. Just tie off the other end of the rope to your arm or your leg or something like that. And remember, when you're aiming in water, to aim below the target due to refraction of light in water. The target will actually be a little bit lower than it looks like in the water. Anyway, I think it's about time we get to making the sling bow, the sling bow itself. So here we have the completed sling bow. I did not film the installation of the whisker biscuit. It was difficult getting in there with my hands and also leaving the space open to use the video camera to film it. But I mean, it's a pretty simple process. You know, put the whisker biscuit right in the Y of the sling and then just thread the zip tie through the openings here and here and pull it tight and you're set. Only word of caution and thing to be careful of when installing the whisker biscuit is to make sure that it comes out this way. You don't want it to be set up so that it can come out that way, because when the arrow comes through, it's going to pop right out. You want it to be able to only be put in from the back. The cheaper models like this, and maybe even the more expensive ones, I'm not sure, they are going to pop out. You're going to have the option to pop them out because the whisker biscuit will eventually lose their tensile strength and they won't hold the arrow as well. So it is made to replace those. In a survival situation, are you going to shoot that many arrows? Yes, but in a survival situation, you're also not going to be able to go to the local sporting goods store and buy another one. So, you know, maybe you could consider super gluing that on there because you're not gonna have the opportunity to put another one on. So it really doesn't matter if this one wears down. You're just gonna have to make the best of what you got. But just something to consider. You don't want that popping out, flying around with the arrow, because you might lose it, and then you have no way to stabilize the front of the arrow aside from using your hands, which I would not recommend. That's basically it. As far as shooting goes, the only tips I really have for that is that, you know, this isn't an exact science. You're not going to shoot 1-inch groups at 30 yards like you can with a compound bow with this or a crossbow. This whole purpose of this sling bow is to be able to kill small game to survive if you're trapped in the wilderness or, you know, whatever your situation might be. There's definitely going to be a learning curve, and I recommend practicing with it. One thing I did realize when shooting this a little bit yesterday was the lighter the arrow, the harder of a time you're going to have, because just the way that this is set up, you know, it's not exact. Every time the arrow is going to fly a little bit differently. It helps to have a heavier arrow. You might even consider, I think there are crossbow bolts that screw in. There are two pieces that screw into one longer piece. I think those heavier pieces might actually be more beneficial because then it gives the arrow less. Because it's heavier, it won't have a tendency to wiggle as much in the air. But that's something I'm going to have to test on my own and come to my own conclusion to what the best type of ammo would be, type of arrows would be to keep with this. So the only other thing I noticed when I was practicing shooting was you have to be conscious of the sling bands. It's not like a regular compound bow where you just stick your arm out straight and you draw. You have to be conscious of the slings, the sling bands, because when you have a compound bow, it's all lateral. The string of the bow is all through the pulley system. It can only really be drawn straight. But with the sling, you have all this play, and if you're not conscious of that, when you go to make a shot, you're going to go like this or like that, and the arrow is going to fly the respective direction. If you have it pulled right, it's going to hook left, and vice versa if you have it to the other side. So something to be cautious of. Best thing to do is try to line the nock, or if you remove it, the golf tee up with the hole of the whisker biscuit. I realized that was gave me a little bit better groups after shooting a couple times. So that's something to consider. But, you know, just like anything else, there's a learning curve, and it's going to take practice before you get something. But even after just 15 minutes, you know, I was probably shooting maybe at 10 yards, a couple inch group, and I wasn't trying that hard. So in a survival situation, you could definitely get a small game animal with this. NoMoreOp4, this is a brief how-to on the sling bow. Hope you guys enjoyed it. NoMoreOp4 out.